the soldiers that came on Friday, the guys in the elite units, were the most impressive to me. When they described what they went through, they described days, weeks, walking with no food. I don't know what a kilo is, but a lot of them on your back isn't very comfortable. And how they managed to go through all of that, and they came out stronger because of it. And it struck me that when you think about war and God protecting the Jewish people through our chayalim, through the people who fight for us, it's not always so pleasant and so much fun. War is very challenging. It's very physical. It probably doesn't feel very spiritual and very warm. On Hanukkah, we celebrate two things. We celebrate a war, and we celebrate a miracle that's almost the exact opposite. A pach shemen, a little jug of oil. We didn't really need it. We could have used the tamei oil. And it lasted for 8 days, and it was just such a nice embrace of HaKadosh Baruch Hu. We just felt like Hashem was giving us a hug at that time. I was thinking that maybe the idea of the two miracles is to show how HaKadosh Baruch Hu is involved in every element of our lives, from the most spiritual to the most physical, but maybe it's something else also. Maybe the message of these two miracles is that life is always full of moments where we feel the closeness of Hashem. And the only way we're going to appreciate those moments, we're going to know what to do with those moments, is if we also take advantage of all of the moments in between. All of the mundane moments. All of the moments that don't seem so special. You know, I asked my Talmidim as an extra credit question on a test. I don't know if it was last year or 2 years ago. It was a very hard question. I asked, list three things about Judaism that are very special to you. Then I asked the second question, list three things about Judaism that are not very special to you, that are very challenging. And on almost everyone's list of the special things was Shabbos. On almost everyone's list of the non-special things was Mincha. And it's interesting, because if one is really going to appreciate Shabbos, if you're really going to appreciate what it means to have HaKadosh Baruch Hu spend some time with us, a person really has to experience the minchas of life as well. You know, we say in Al Anisim, we celebrate, we talk all about the war, and then we say, Va'achar Kein. And afterwards we went in and we lit the menorah, because the only way we're going to appreciate lighting the menorah is if it's first, if first we have the war, if it's preceded by the war. In 1967, there was a major event in the Jewish people. We got back the Kotel. We had a speaker in yeshiva about 15 years ago that told us that he had a son that was born shortly after the Kotel Biadenu, shortly after we got back the Kotel. And he was so inspired by the whole event. It was such a moment for the Jewish people. This speaker told us that he named his son Yisrael Yair, that Israel should give off light, because he was so inspired by the incredible event. And obviously you're probably aware that baby grew up to be our Rebbe, our Rosh Yeshiva, Rabbi Kamenetsky. Now, in that moment, there was another fellow that was alive at that time who was a major general in the army and later went on to become the prime minister, Ariel Sharon. And Ariel Sharon was at the Kotel, and a chassid came over to him and gave him a pair of tefillin. Ariel Sharon was as secular as you get. He would never put on tefillin, probably never did before that day, and probably never again after that day. And a reporter asked him, I don't understand. When you came to the Western Wall, a chassid gave you a pair of tefillin and asked you to wear them, and you did it. Why suddenly the religious fervor? And he answered, yeah, I did do it. I did put on the tefillin. And he explained, when I came to the Kotel, I had very deep feelings and I wanted to express those feelings. But to my dismay, I discovered that li ein milim, li yehudi dati yesh. I didn't have the vocabulary to express those feelings. Religious Jews have the vocabulary to express those feelings. I had no context in my life to appreciate what was going on. A religious Jew has the context to appreciate what was going on. Rav Yosef Nechemya Kornitzer writes that Lahadlik Ner Shel Chanukah, the Rashi Tevos, if you scramble them, is Shulchan. If one wants to appreciate the Neros Chanukah, it's important that a person experiences the Shulchan of Judaism. What we do at our table in the Beis Medrash, what we do at our table in Shul, if you daven in a Shul that has tables, what we do at our table at home, how we act day in and day out, it's only if we have that kind of dedication, if we take care of the minchas of our lives, that we'll be able to appreciate the chanukahs of our lives.